Hello everybody, I got a new toy, and this is going to be a how-to video on how to install a Thompson Fat Pad on a bench that's not a Rogue bench. So, this is what the Thompson Fat Pad looks like. It's fat, and it's a pad. It's a Thompson Fat Pad. So, this thing has the typical understated Rogue type branding on it. So, gosh, I wonder who makes this thing. So here it is, and it comes with these holes standard on it, so I'm going to flip it on its tummy here. All right, there we go. So it's got a couple sets of holes, which I presume will bolt directly into certain Rogue benches. They do not bolt right into the Titan bench that I've got. So here's the Titan bench. I've just got the inexpensive Titan flat bench. I mean, as far as a platform goes, it's pretty sturdy. I'm relatively happy with it. There are some things that I might look at in the future where maybe it's got this, but then just a single leg down there. But I don't really want to spring for a new bench right now. There, you know, I'd be looking at another $150 or something. So I'm going to just mount this thing on my Titan bench. So here are the holes on the Titan bench. There's one there, one in the middle, and one there. So let me put this on the Thompson Fat Pad, and we'll see how it lines up. So we can see as far as lining up, it doesn't. The hole is here, but then the Rogue holes are just a little inch or so away. The middle hole doesn't have any hole drilled in the Thompson Fat Pad. And then this hole is here, so I'm going to need to put holes in the Thompson Fat Pad. How the heck do we do this? When I pulled the Titan pad off, these were the bolts that were attaching it. They're too small in these Rogue holes, so draw your own dirty innuendo there. But they're too small, so this won't work. I need to find these little things. They're called inserts. And so I went to try and find them at Lowe's. This must be some type of non-standard thread because the inserts they had did not work. So I just went with very slightly larger bolts and inserts. So this is what they look like. They're Hillman and then some foreign language. But it's wood insert nuts. And so they're made of brass. And so what I need to do is drill holes into the plywood on the bottom of this fat pad and then screw these inserts into the plywood. And then after that, I will put the new bolts in. Again, the Titan bolts were some kind of non-standard thread. Maybe you can buy these inserts somewhere for the Titan bolts. I couldn't find them at Lowe's. So I got just ever so slightly larger bolts. So I'll put these in with a washer and a lock nut. Okay, so I cut away the fabric right here in the middle hole, and I'm going to go ahead and drill my hole. As it turned out, I really did need to use the half inch. This thing's in there. It's not totally straight, but it's in. So we'll see how it goes. I'm going to try to make sure that the bolts still thread through okay. One of the new ones. It's supposed to go in like this, and that's not too bad. I mean, it's not the straightest thing in the world, but this thing doesn't need to be that tight on the tolerances. You know, just a fraction of an inch here, there'd be all right. So, all right, so I've got the first one in there. Okay, so now from this middle one, and I figured the middle is always going to be the middle. All right, that's as tight as I can get it. Then I need to put one here and here, get a measuring tape here. So from the center of the first hole to the center of the second hole is about 17 3/4 inches. Between 17 and 5, probably 17 and 11 sixteenths. So we need a hole there, and we need a hole right about there. That's where I want one of them. And I want the other one to be here right at the 7-inch mark, right about there. Okay, so time to cut the fabric and drill the holes. Okay, there's that one ready to go. And let's get Mr. Drill going here. I want to mark the depth there. Roughly. All right, and see if we can drill straight there. I don't know what exactly the plywood is they use here, but the first layer of it, the veneer, is very hard. Yeah, actually that 1/2 inch is the perfect size for these inserts. And once you get them in a little bit, you can do this with them. They're turn a little bit easier this way. Give it a little leverage. If you lift weights, you know all about leverage. There we go. Make sure we didn't damage the threads too much. Alright, so that one's good. And this is why we dry fit things. This hole that I put in is 1 inch off. I actually measured 1 inch wrong. This is why I bought extra hardware too. I do this stuff all the time. So the hole should actually be 1 inch closer. Okay, for this last one, I really can't afford for it to be offline, so I got out the drywall T-square, so I just have a straight edge. So I can make sure that it'll be relatively perfectly in line with the other two. Looks like it's going to be, and also so that it won't wander, I'm going to use something called a Forstner bit. It's got a little brad point in it, so this way, the starting point of the hole, sometimes drill bits will wander a little bit when you try to use them, so Forstner bits don't. Forstner bits also give you a flat bottom hole. This thing cuts its own threads as it goes in, so I want it to be as straight as possible when it starts. And now for the moment of truth, we'll see if it'll go on. They're all threading or cross-threading. I won't know until I try and drive them further. That one worked for sure. All right, that's relatively snug. This guy on this side is actually really smooth. So with practice, you get better. So this one probably is more vertical than the other ones. All right, now middle guy. I don't think he's crossed there. I think he's just kind of at a funky angle. Yeah, that's, there we go. All right, yeah. We're tight. All right. Let's flip it over and see what we got. Okay, ta-da, there we go. It's on there, complete with my laundry. That's actually clean laundry in the basket. I just haven't folded it. I know I get dirty laundry in here. But yeah, it's on there. Seems to be really solid. I'll have to try it later, but there we go. Thompson Fat Pad. Overall, I would not rate this project as easy, but definitely doable, so give it a shot. Good luck with it. So basically, that thing went about like I expected it would, so I would recommend giving it a shot if you're interested in the Thompson Fat Pad. Other than that, I'll try working out with it on my next bench press day. So have a great workout, everybody. We'll see you soon.